First of all, I'd like to thank you for giving us the support all this while and make it possible for a change of government in Selangor. I have been in the State Assembly for the fourth term since 1995. And all this while, I've been telling the Barisan Nasional that one day we are going to take over Selangor from you. And true enough, in 2008, we make it. We make it because of you, because of your support. They said we are green. We don't know, we don't have experience. We are inexperienced, we are green. Yes, we are green, we don't have experience. But at the same time, we don't have experience of taking bribe. We don't have experience of giving contract to our cronies because we don't have cronies before. We don't have the experience of having cronies. But for the past 20 months after being a government, we have proven that we can manage. And we can manage better than Barisan Nasional. And you know about it. From Penang, even Perak, Selangor, we have proven. We have proven that we can manage better than Barisan Nasional. And now we say, managing the state, we are not happy. Because we are going to Putrajaya now. For the past 20 months, it has not been an easy time for us. As I mentioned by Tan Sri Khalid just now, Selangor contributed 16 billion a year through income tax to the federal government. And in return, the grant given back to Selangor is a meager sum of 400 million only. It is only 0.255% of the total taxes that we pay to the federal government through income tax. We give them 60 billion, we give them 16 billion, and they give us in return only 0.255, 400 million. Now, since they refuse to give us a fair and reasonable amount, we're going to Putrajaya to take all back from them. And we know we can do it. We know we can do it. Malaysia is a rich country. Selangor is rich. We are blessed with all kinds of resources. But what has Barisan Nasional do for the past 52 years? Abuse of powers, corruptions, malpractices. You look through, if you have the opportunity to read the Auditor's General Report, you will see. We buy a laptop, $4,000, you can get a good one. Really good one, $4,000. But for the government, they have to spend $40,000 for one laptop. That is why Malaysia almost goes bankrupt. In Malaysia, we have everything we want. Our soil is fertile. Whatever you plant on Malaysia Earth, you get. You plant rubber, you get rubber. You plant oil palm, you get oil palm. You plant peanut, you get peanut. If you don't plant anything, lalang will grow. And you have to spend money on it. The country is rich. We have petroleum. But where has the money gone? All gone to the cronies' pocket. And that is why, after 52 years, we are still way behind Singapore. Singapore is nothing, but we are way behind them, despite the resources that we have. We say we can manage. They say, okay, for Selangor, it's a small place. It's only one of the 13 states in Malaysia. You may be able to do it, but you are not capable of running a federal government. You don't even have a prime minister to run it. We say, yes, we have Prime Minister, we have the choice, we have the candidate. Datu Sri Anwar, he's capable enough. He's more capable than Najib. Certainly he's more capable than Abdullah Badawi. We have a candidate. But then what they say? Then they charge Anwar Ibrahim for the second time. For breaking the back door of a young man. And he break the record. Datu Sri Anwar has broken the record He is the only one in the world that has been charged twice for breaking the back door of a young man. And they brought the young man together with the statutory declarations. He said that on this day, this time, Anwar Ibrahim has broken my back door. But in this country, we still believe in judiciary. We still believe in evidence. Therefore, the guy called Saiful has to be sent to hospital for a medical checkup. A Burmese doctor has done a thorough checkup and he wrote the report. He said, after examinations, I found that the back door of Saiful has not been broken into. The lock is still intact. But yet, despite the report from the doctor, then he decided to charge Dato Sri Anwar. And as you know, anyone who has said something against the wish of the government of Barisan Nasional, they will disappear. And true enough, after disclosing his report, the Burmese doctor also disappeared. So after that, now come the principal of the hospital. And he said, don't believe that Burmese doctor. Not because he's a Burmese doctor. Not because he's a Burmese. Because he's not a specialist on back door. I've heard of brain specialists, eye specialists, cardiologists, but I've never heard of back door specialists. So if your children want to study medicine, make sure that you advise them, please go and do this specialist. Backdoor specialist. Shameful Malaysia. Shameful Malaysia to have incident like this. And then that is why. That is why the perception of Malaysia is deteriorating every day, every moment. And I will say that whenever you go to overseas, especially when you go to China, when the people there ask you, where do you come from? More often than not, the answer is, I come from Singapore. We are too shy that we are Malaysians. Because of Barisan Nasional. Because of Barisan Nasional. And now, we have exhausted all the resources. We have to rely on tourism. So they have appointed, Najib has appointed Ng Yen Yen to be the tourism minister. And she has gone around the world to do promotion. Sometimes together with our Elizabeth. And what did he say about, what did she promote about Malaysia? He said, Malaysia is the best place in the world. You can buy everything here. It's a heaven for shopping. Yes, it is true. Malaysia is a heaven for shopping. You can buy whatever you want. Whatever you want, Malaysia can offer. And there are three things that Malaysia has, but you can't find it in any other country. That makes Malaysia heaven for shopping. Firstly, in Malaysia, you can buy the police. You can't buy in any other places, you can buy in Malaysia. You can buy the police. Secondly, if you have employed a maid without permit, and you got into trouble, never mind. The immigration can be bought. So you can buy the immigration too. Now, if you cannot settle with the police and you cannot settle the immigration, don't worry. Go to court. We can buy the judge. Get Vika Lingam to do so. This is the bad shape of Malaysia. Everything is corrupt. Every department is corrupt. And that is the reason why we say we need a change. We have been shortchanged for the past 52 years. And as a state government, Pakatan Rakyat did not get the fair deal. And of course, this is because of the framework of the federal constitutions. Based on the federal constitution, there are only two grants that the federal government will give to the state government. One is a capitation grant, which the sum is meagre. And the other grant is a grant for maintenance of the state roads. As I said, we have only 0.255% of all the taxes that we give to the federal government. And therefore, we need to change the federal constitution. We need to amend the federal constitution to give a fair deal to the states. But that is not enough. We are not complacent. We are not content to be the state government. We want to be in Putrajaya because we need to change. We need to reform the judiciary. We need to reform the legislature. We need to reform the executive. And therefore, we need your support, your continued support, to make sure that next round, in next generation, we can make it in Putrajaya. With that, I thank you for your support. Hopefully, next round we come, all the ministers from Pakatan will be here with you. Thank you. Good night.